Marichat hesitated. Perched on the balcony of Marinette's home, he frowned as he debated on bothering her. He leaped painfully down and limped over to the glass door. He raised his hand and knocked quietly, as did not alert her parents. He gritted his teeth as a painful surge flew down his leg. He tried to ignore it and knocked again. The door opened, and Marinette sleepily rubbed her eyes and squinted at him with a scowl.
"Shut," she muttered. "What are you doing here?"
she asked, shaking her head to clear her sleepiness. Shot ignored his pain and tried to put on a charming smile.
"Hey, I was kind of wondering if you could maybe help me out a little?"
he asked awkwardly, rubbing the back of his neck as he spoke. Marinette stared at him with confusion and slowly looked down at the blood dripping from his leg and onto the floor. Her eyes widened as she cupped her mouth and shot.
"Oh my gosh, Shot! What happened to you? Get in here!"
she stumbled on as she grabbed his arm and tucked him inside her room.
"Sit here. I'll get the first aid kit," she said, pushing him onto her bed.
He nodded and watched her go into the bathroom. He looked around at the dim light in the room. Pictures of him smiling face. He paused and blinked in shock. Why was he, Adrien, on her wall? He was snapped from his thoughts as Marinette came rushing back into the room, holding the first aid kit. She sat it down and started rumbling through it. She pulled everything she needed and looked up at him in concern.
This is going to hurt,
she warned. Her blue eyes reflected her true feelings of fear and worry. He smiled at her and cupped her face gently.
Don't you worry, princess. I'll be okay. I'm used to getting kicked around from the Akuma. This will be a piece of cake,
he beamed at her, trying to soothe her nerves. She lightly smiled and shook her head.
I don't know why you're being so calm when you're bleeding. What even happened?
She asked as she pressed some disinfectant on the wound. He winced and instead focused his eyes on the wall.
Well, funny story on that one, he gave a chuckle.
It was after Ladybug left me for the night. I was running along a rooftop when I kind of stepped a loose shingle and slipped. I slid down the roof and fell into a sharp-pointed fence. Needless to say, it hurt. I guess it was just my bad luck again. You know what they say about black cats and all. He laughed. She looked up at him with an amused smile.
Of course that's how you got hurt.
She said with a light eye roll.
Just because your costume is black doesn't mean you have a bad luck, you know.
She teased. He looked at her with a mock hurt.
What's that supposed to mean? Of course I have bad luck. It's quite powerful if you ask me, he said. Much like your puns, she muttered as she wiped the dirt from the cut. Almost done, she said as she wrapped gauze on it and sat back on her feet. There, all done, she said, closing up the first aid kit.
You're lucky it wasn't bad, she said. He explained it with a bright smile and gave her a thumbs up.
Perfect. Thanks, princess, he put her. So I can ask you something, he asked.
She frowned and nodded. Go for it, she said. He smiled shyly and stared at his left.
Why do you have pictures of Adrien on your wall? Do you like him or something? He asked awkwardly.
He glared at her quietly, quickly, seeing if he had overstepped.
Chat looked at her with wide eyes. Really? Why? was there to like about him? He asked in shock. She looked at him like he had grown three heads.
Well, she started. He's really cute, and he's always really kind. He has a good heart, and he's always so polite to everyone. He never steps out of line. He seems always eager to please others. He's so nice and dreamy, she finished, clasping her hands together while she was lost in her thoughts. He frowned.
What if that's not the real him? Would you still like him? He asked after a moment. She looked at him with a raised brow.
What do you mean? Of course that's the real him. Why would he fake that?
You wouldn't understand. You never met him.
You wouldn't understand. You never met him, she said. If you had, then you'd understand what I'm talking about, she said confidently.
He looked at the pictures on the wall once more and frowned at the forced smiles on his face. He remembered how unhappy he'd been the day those were taken, and how he was forced to wear that sweatshirt, and he was told to smile. What if the real him liked a certain spotted girl and told silly jokes, he asked, glancing back at her with a sheepish smile, and rubbed the back of his neck at her odd look.
You know, just in theory, he said, covering his mistake. She thought for a moment.
Well, then I'd have to tell him that I sort of admire Black Cat, and they're not really a stubborn mess.
She joked with a giggle, looking into his green eyes. He blushed and looked down.
Yeah. Why do you get into a certain fit when you speak to me? He asked quietly.
He looked at her after a moment when she didn't answer him.
She was staring at him in wide-eyed confusion.
Me?
She asked, his eyes widening, and he held up his hands.
I mean, not me. you know, I meant around him.
He stumbled, cursing his slip. She stared at him.
Shut, who are you really?
She asked as she looked right into his eyes.
I know you, don't I?
She asked quietly.
I gotta go. Thanks for the first aid help, he said, staring with a grin.
It was lovely, princess. Have a nice night, he said, stepping towards the window.
But I gotta go and meet Ladybug. She's waiting for me, he lied.
She stood and crossed her arms. She raised a brow and latched into his arm.
You're not going anywhere, kitty, she shoved him back onto the
oof.
Ladybug isn't waiting for you, she said with a scowl.
He frowned.
How would you know that? He asked with confusion.
She rolled her eyes. First answer my question. Who are you?
She asked as she stood in front of him. He squirmed under her relentless gaze and let out a held breath in surrender.
Fine. Plague claws in, he said in defeat.
The room was filled with green light, and then it cleared, leaving Adrien sitting there awkwardly. He slowly looked up into her shocked face.
She just stared at him with an open mouth. It was you this whole time?
She mumbled as she stumbled backwards. She shook her head.
Oh, my God! I was right next to you for years! I kissed you!
She said in horror, cupping her hands over her mouth.
He was totally confused.
I called you Kitty! Holy, I can't believe this!
She kept chanting as she plopped into her chair and sat down. Why would you call me Kitty?
Only Ladybug does that,
he slowly said and paused. He looked at her with careful eyes, taking every detail of her. He noticed the same colored hair and how it was in pigtails. He looked into her eyes, the same eyes he looked into for years and had fallen in love with.
Ladybug?
He said in dismay. He stood from the bed and stared at her.
"Are you really Ladybug?" he asked. She rolled her eyes and looked at the floor.
"Quite a disappointment, eh?" she said with her first laugh. "Sorry I let you down," she said.
Bisoy walked over to her and knelt down next to her. He took her hand into his and begged her.
"You are not a disappointment. In fact, you're just as beautiful as I've always pictured you to be."
He smiled at her and raised her hand to his lips and kissed him.
She looked at him. "You don't mean that," she said.
"Of course I mean it. The first time I laid eyes on you, I told myself I was in love with a girl under the mask. I didn't fall in love with a spotted suit. I fell in love with you.
The girl under the suit," he smiled at her. "I fell in love with you, my lady," he said.
She smiled at him.
"You said that?" she asked.
He nodded.
"I did. I just wish I figured this out sooner. I mean, it's not like I didn't try. It's just I didn't even think of someone in the same class as I.
Kind of stupid, huh?" he chuckled.
She shook her head. "I never even looked at Adrien's being a silly pun-making cat."
She giggled at the thought.
"I was so close to you, and I didn't even know it," she laughed.
"I don't know how I didn't see it. I must be so thick.
You have the same hair and the same style. You have the same eye color as Ladybug. Plus, you always disappear when danger comes."
He shook his head at the thought.
"Yeah, yeah. You're both stupid. Can you get this over with already? I'm hungry!"
Flag whined. Marinette's eyes widened, she looked behind Adrien, spotting Flag floating there, his arms crossed.
"Who's that?" she asked, pointing to the Kwame.
Adrien looked at Flag with a bright grin.
"That's my Kwame, Flag. He's the cat god of bad luck and destruction.
Fun, huh?
Bad attitude to go with. Oh, and he likes to eat stinky cheese, too."
He teased, earning him a glare from Flag. Tiki then flew out and tackled Flag with a tight pull.
"Oh, I missed you so much," she said warmly.
Flag pushed her off and rolled his eyes.
"Whatever."
Mari pointed to Tiki.
"That's my Kwame. Her name's Tiki. She's the goddess of luck and creation. She's super nice and she loves cookies," she said.
Adrien frowned. "Lucky. Not fair that you get the pleasant one." He whined when playfulness made Marinette giggle.
"You're lucky you even stick around, kid,"
Flag hissed, flying over to Adrien's coat and sticking him inside.
"Let's go home. I'm starving," he yelled.
Adrien grinned. "We better be going. I'll see you tomorrow then, my lady," he asked as he gave a mock bow. She nodded.
"Yeah, tomorrow," she beamed at him.
"Great, I'll see you then. Flag, claws out," he said as green light filled the room, and he was once again chinois. He flashed a charming smile and gave a bow as he left. She could hardly contain the excitement at finding out Adrien was her partner. Then it hit her.
Adrien was her partner. The boy she was in love with for years was the cat flirting with her on a nightly basis?
She claimed at that, and how dumb she had been.
"Oh, Tiki, I'm a fool sometimes."
She laughed as she fell back onto her bed with a thud and let out a sigh.
"Adrien is Chinoir, and Chinoir is Adrien. That'll take time to get used to,"
she said as she rolled over and turned out the light.
"But I can return Shot's feelings now."
She smiled at that and went to sleep, looking forward to the patrol tomorrow.